video, we'll walk through some basic as well as advanced cloud CDN configurations in the Google Cloud Console. We'll try to explain the concepts simply and also clarify the architecture with a diagram. We'll wrap up by looking at important interfaces for cache and validation and monitoring. So, I have an existing load balancer here, but one that does not yet have Cloud CDN enabled. This load balancer is backed by a serverless network endpoint group, and specifically a Cloud Run service. The service echoes back properties of our HTTP request for testing and debugging. If I edit the load balancer to enable Cloud CDN, we'll see the various configurability points. First off, we have the caching mode, which has a recommended option pre-selected. With this option, files like CSS, JavaScript, and fonts will be cached, and without the need to configure the caching in our backends. That is, the content type of the response is checked against the list to decide if and how Cloud CDN should cache the content. The next option we have is the use origin settings, which is caching based on cache control headers. So this means the responsibility for cache configuration falls on our Cloud Run service or whatever backends that we have behind the load balancer. When we set the cache control headers at the origin server level, we have really fine-grained control over caching. We could potentially even configure caching on a per-file level. Finally, we have this force cache all content option. As the name implies, this means that all files behind the load balancer will automatically be cached. When we have a setting other than use origin settings, by using cache static content or force cache all content, we're going to configure the caching behavior at this load balancer level. Here, we configure the usual client time to live, default time to live, and maximum time to live settings. Of the three caching modes, this first one is perhaps the trickiest, since it does not include some files that we might have in static websites like HTML. The reason for that is that we may have server-side rendered HTML, which contains user-specific or customized content. We wouldn't want those customized HTML files to be cached and then potentially exposed to other users. So, deliberately, we don't have those files included in that cache mode. To understand exactly what content types are cached, you'll want to carefully consult the documentation, which we'll link in the description of this video. Now, let's look at the advanced configurations as well. First, let's look at the serve stale setting. This means that Cloud CDN will serve cached content even if the backend origin is offline or throwing errors. So, for example, if our Cloud Run service behind this load balancer went down, then this setting could enable the continued serving of cached content. If you decide to enable this setting, you'll need to choose an associated duration. Next up, we have restricted content, which means that we can use signed URLs or signed cookies to control access to the cache. Requiring authorization for the cache is a somewhat unusual use case, as you'll typically want public access. Next, we have a negative caching policy. With this setting, when we have HTTP responses with error codes, we can actually cache those responses. This is not enabled by default. For example, if we have a website 404 page that has very high traffic, we may actually want to cache that 404 response, just like how we would cache 200 response code content. Lastly, we can bypass the cache based on request headers. This is also a bit of an unusual setting, but allows us to control caching behavior from the client side. Let's very quickly map out the caching architecture in a diagram to clarify the concepts. So, in front here, we have this cloud load balancer. And integrated with that, we have our Cloud CDN. Finally, we have our Cloud Run service at the very end here. This is the origin server for our demonstrated use case. So the flow is generally going to look like this. Our load balancer will reach out to see if there's cache content in Cloud CDN. If we're supposed to serve a cache in that situation and the content is actually cached, then we'll serve the request from there and not even touch our Cloud Run origin server. In the cases where we don't want to cache or don't have the particular content cached, the request will be forwarded to those backend origin servers. While I'm highlighting Cloud Run, this could also be things like a cloud storage bucket, a Kubernetes service, or a Compute Engine VM. In our cloud load balancing configuration, these backends will look slightly different. For example, we may use a regional network endpoint group over Compute Engine VMs, but a serverless network endpoint group over a Cloud Run service. However, in any case, the backend is our origin server and basically acts in the same way as far as the CDN is concerned. Returning to the console, let's recap and apply our configuration. So we've walked through all the configurations that refine and control that cloud CDN caching architecture. If you have either the first cache mode or the third cache mode, then we'll be configuration heavy at the load balancer level. Meanwhile, if you use the second cache mode, the caching configuration will largely fall on the origin servers via cache control headers. Let's now enable this configuration and update our load balancer. Okay, so let's move on to the important last part of the process, cache management, debugging, and monitoring. First, we'll have cache invalidation with this caching page. We don't yet have access to that page, but once the load balancer updates, we will. So here on this caching page, we have the option to invalidate our cache. This means clearing Cloud CDN for this load balancer so that the cache is refilled from our origin servers. This could be useful if, for example, we have a major application update. In that case, we may want to invalidate certain parts of the cache or the entire cache so that all users are seeing the newly updated files. Moving on to visibility, if we go to the Cloud CDN page, this is where you'll see important monitoring and reporting. We can, for example, see the cache hit percentage, bandwidth, fill rate, and request volumes. If, on this page, you have a 0% cache hit rate, then you'll know that there was an issue, or at least unexpected behavior, from the configurations that we talked about earlier. We hope that this overview has been helpful, and we'll link documentation in the description of this video. We'll also monitor the comments for any questions or concerns, and want to thank you for watching.